Hello students, today we are going to study one poem, The Brook. Brook is a small stream, jharna. Yes, it is about the journey of the brook. Here the poem is like the autobiography of the brook itself. So here I refers to the brook. So the brook is describing its journey. So from where does it start and where does it stop? And how is it joining the main river? What all things are coming in between? And how the water is continuously flowing without a stop? I come from horns of coot and hern. I make a sudden sally and sparkle out among the fern to bicker down a valley. So here the brook is saying that I come from horns of coot and hern. Now coot and hern is water animal, birds. And horns means the place where coot and hern is living, dwelling place, living place. So from where is the brook coming? It is coming from the place where coot and hern are living. They are the water birds. I make a sudden sally. I jump, quickly jump and sparkle out among the fern. So during the daytime, the sun shines and during the daytime, because of sun, the water shines to bicker down a valley and directly it flows down the valley. So as it is coming fast, there is a sound, right? So that is called as bicker. By 30 hills I hurry down or slip between the ridges. By 20 thropes a little town and half a hundred bridges. So he is saying, Brook is saying that it is coming from 30 hills, then it is passing through the mountains, then villages, thropes means villages, and it also it is passing through bridges. Now here 30, 20, is it really that itna hi wo isne hi hills mein and itne hi villages ko pass kar rahi hai kya? No, this is just for poetic effect. Till last by Philip's farm I flow, to join the brimming river, for men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. Here, this line is very important as the brook is saying that I am the nature, I will be always present, unlike human beings. Human beings aaj rahenge, kal mar jayenge. But nature is always with you. So we should take care of nature. Till last by Philip's farm I flow. So at the end it comes to the Philip's farm and it joins the brimming river, overflowing river ko wo stream jharna aake mil jata hai. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. Log aayenge, log jayenge, but main hamesha rahunga, always everlasting. Yes? I chatter over stony ways. So now as it is passing through the stones, we must have heard the sound, yes, of the water. So chatter is talk. In little sharps and trembles, I bubble into eddying bays, I babble on the pebbles. So now ye brook kya bata raha hai, jaise wo stony ways ke paas aa raha hai, to awaaz aata hai, wo baat kar raha hai. जोर जोर से म्यूजिकल साउंड्स आ रहा है, मतलब ज़ोर से वो पटक रहा है पानी उसके ऊपर. सो जोर से आवाज़ आ रहा है. शार्प्स एंड ट्रेम्बल्स आर द म्यूजिकल साउंड्स. आई बबल इन टू एडिंग बेस, आई बैबल ऑन टू द पेबल्स. सो बबल्स आ रहे हैं मुझे क्योंकि मैं फास्ट जा रहा हूँ. सिमिलरली बैबल ऑन द पेबल्स, पेबल्स आर द स्टोन्स. सो आई एम टॉकिंग समथिंग, बैबल इज टू टॉक समथिंग. With many a curb my banks I fret, by many a field and fallow, and many a fairy foreland set with willow weed and mallow. So as I am flowing, I come and I change the directions. So isse kya ho raha hai, jo banks hai, river banks, they get angry, they fret out, they wear out, no, they get anxious, angry. By many a field and fallow, fields से मैं पास हो रहा हूँ, fallow lands से plants वो lands है, ज़मीन से मैं पास हो रहा हूँ. And many a fairy foreland set with willow weed and mallow. सो फेरी फोर लैंड, ब्यूटिफुल लैंड से भी मैं पास हो रहा हूँ जिसमें वीड्स है एंड मैलो है. वीड्स आर द अनवांटेड प्लांट्स एंड मैलो मीन्स प्लांट्स विच हैज पर्पल फ्लावर्स. I chatter, chatter as I flow to join the brimming river. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. So this paragraph is repeated. For this lines, two lines are repeated. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. Means nature is all will be always with us. Sorry, we should always take care of nature. Next, I wind about and in and out with here a blossom sailing. So I move here and there, and whenever I am moving, there are some flowers also with me. And here and there a lusty trout, and here and there a grayling. And whenever I am flowing, I may get some fishes also with me. So lusty trout and grayling, these are the type of fish. And here and there a foamy flake upon me as I travel. So when there is a huge pressure, pani zor se pressure se aega to foam jaisa lagta hai, foam is white white color, with many a silvery water break upon the golden gravel. So jaise jaise main, so this is with many a silvery water break, the color of the water above the golden gravel. Gravel is also the stone. So the journey, how it flows, and draw them all along and flow to join the brimming river. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. So the water, the brook, is taking everybody along with it, and it is flowing together and then joining the brimming river. And again it is saying, for men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. Ever, लोग आए जाए, आते रहेंगे जाते रहेंगे, but I will be forever. I slip, I slide, I glue my glance. So पानी वो उसका movements बता रहा है. Among my skimming swallows. Now swallow is a bird, and skimming swallows means birds आ रहे हैं, सिर्फ they are just coming and touching the water and again flying away. I make the netted sunbeam dance against my sandy shallows. Netted sunbeam dance means पानी के आसपास plants रहते हैं, and उनके ऊपर जब sunlight गिरता है तो net जैसे दिखने लगता है. Yes, against my sandy shallows, and आसपास sand है which is shallow, not deep. I murmur under moon and stars in brambly wilderness. So murmur is to speak in a very low voice. Again it is related to the movement. In brambly wilderness, bramble is a fruit, berry. I linger by my shingly bars, I loiter round my cresses. So I move here and there, I shine, yes, and I move around the plants. And out again I curve and flow to join the brimming river. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. So I come, I get, I turn, twist, curve hoti hu, mera flow alag ho jate hain. But again, at the end, I am joining the main river, the flowing river. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. Main rukungi nahi. I am always... I will be always present. So here it is related to nature. So with us, nature will be there forever. Yes, nature will be there with us always. See your children. Did you understand this poem? Okay. See, who is the speaker in the poem? Who is speaking? Right. The brook is the speaker. Which lines are repeated in the poem and what do they mean? Right. The lines, for men may come and men may go, but I go on forever, are repeated. They mean that nature is immortal, whereas we are mortal. Immortal matlab kabhi nahi marenge, amar. Yes. Men are born and will die, but nature is eternal, always present. Where does the brook join the river? Yes, the brook joins the river near the Phillips farm. Then mention various places that the brook flows past. कहाँ कहाँ से आ रहा है वो? The brook flows past the dwellings of Coot and Hern. Fern is a flowerless plant. Then town, villages, valleys, hills, ridges, several bridges and Phillips farm. Yes, children? Now see here. What does the chattering sound of the brook seem like? क्या लगता है हमको? कैसे लगता है वो? The chattering sound of the broom seems like musical sounds. Next, why does the bank fret? क्यों उसको थोड़ा गुस्सा आ रहा है? The bank frets because the brook changes its shape quite often by curving. ये कौन सा bank है? River bank. The brook mentions exact number of hills, villages and bridges. What does it mean? 20, 30 numbers बताए हैं. उसका exact meaning क्या है? The brook mentions exact numbers to maintain the rhythm of the poem. It actually means that it flows past several hills, villages and bridges. वो सिर्फ एक poetic effect के लिए है. Actual में वो बहुत सारे hills से pass हो रहा है, villages से pass हो रहा है and bridges से pass हो रहा है. Yes? What do we learn from the brook? हम क्या सीख रहे हैं ये poem से? The brook teaches us to be cheerful and enjoy what we do. So whatever we are doing, we should be happy in doing that. It also teaches us that we should never stop when we come across obstacles. रुकना नहीं चाहिए अगर कुछ problems आ गया तो. We should try and try and we should get success. With grit and patience, we should overcome these obstacles and achieve our goals. जो भी कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स है वो सब हम लोग पेशेंस रखेंगे एंड हार्डवर्क करते रहेंगे तो वी कैन गेट आवर गोल्स क्लियर्ड. यस, गुड. होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड दिस पोएम. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट डू लेट मी नो. यस, थैंक यू.